हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज ए प्रोफेसर मोची एस, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंटोमोलॉजी, केकेवा कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर, नासिक. टुडे आई विल टीच यू द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ योर सिलेबस. द नेम इज द स्टडी ऑफ पेस्ट ऑफ राइस एंड देयर मैनेजमेंट. बट before starting our lecture, I would like to tell you some of the important things, such as this information is only for educational purpose and not for commercial. So let us start our chapter or topic, paste of rice. These are the different paste of rice. In that, sucking pest, stem borers, defoliators, then leaf folder, gall midge, case worm, rice hispa, and some of the non-insect pests like mites, field rat, and crab. Let us see one by one. And this is a relative importance of insect pest of rice in India. If you see this diagram, there are near about the 29% of the yield is losses by only a single pest. The name is stem borer. It means that the stem borer, it is the most serious pest of rice. The next one is a brown plant hopper. 16% yield is losses. Then next one is a gall midge, then leaf folder, then white black plant hopper, then green leaf hopper, and then 14% it is losses by the other than this insect pest. And this is the seasonal occurrence of the different major pest of rice. If you see in the stem borer, it is a severe attack in October, January and March month. Then in case of gall midge, it is occurs severe in case of September. Then brown plant hopper, October and November having a serious problem. Also the March and April having a serious problem. It means that there are the some of the important pests which it is a mostly active during the some of the month in the year. Then let us see one by one. The first one is yellow stem borer, Scirrhophaga insertulus. It is the Lepidopteran pest. It means they have a four different life stages. This is the adult, the male and female. And there is a difference between the male and females of the Scirrhophaga insertulus, and this is nothing but the monophagous pest of rice. It means that there is only a single host, that is the rice, which infests by this pest. This is the life cycle of the yellow stem borer. There are the four different life stages: egg, larva, pupa, and adult. The egg laying, after the male-female mating, the egg laying, the female moth lay their eggs on the upper surface of the leaves near the tips. Then after they hatching from the eggs, the larval stages emerge out, that is the caterpillar, and the caterpillar, it is the damaging stage of the yellow stem borer. Then after the fifth instar larva, the larvae goes into the pupation, and the pupation takes place inside the stem of the rice. Then this pest is hibernate in the larval or pupal stage in the stubbles during the winter season, and it is carried over to the next season. Then if you see the nature of damage of the yellow stem borer, is that it is the most dominant and destructive pest, and after the hatching from the eggs, the larva enter into the rice shoots and feeding in the inner content of the shoots and produce a characteristic symptoms. In the vegetative phase, it produces dead hearts, and in case of a reproductive stage, it produces white ears. If you see in a vegetative stage, the larvae feed on the green tissue of the leaf sheath for 2 to 3 days, then bore into the stem at the nodal position and feed on the inner tissue of the plant. Under severe condition, it bores at the base and move upwards the central leaf holes. Central leaf host does not unfold, turns brown and dries off. The lower leaves remain green. It means that At the vegetative stage, it feeds inside the stem or inside the inner container of the shoots and produce a dead husk. And in case of a reproductive stage, the larvae bore into the peduncle node, and then white heads are the resultant effect and damage is maximum at this stage. It means that if you see in the yield losses, in early planted, the crop is losses near about 1 to 19%, and in case of late planted crop, losses is near about the 38 to 80%. It means that avoid late transplanting of the rice because the infestation of the yellow stem borer is very much in high damage. Okay, then in this picture, the left side picture or the first picture, this is the egg laying habit of the yellow stem borer at the tip of the leaves in a masses. Then after it enter into the rice shoot and feeding inner container of the shoots and produce a dead husk. In the left side picture, this is the dead husk at the vegetative stage, and in the right side picture, there is a white ears at the reproductive stage. Then how we can manage this pest? Before managing the pest, we should know about the ETA level of that particular pest. In this year, the yellow stem borer, the 5 to 10% dead husk or the 2% ears or the 1 moth per meter square and 2 egg masses per meter square are the ETA levels of the yellow stem borer. Then after, we can go for the management practices. For monitoring of the pest, you can set up the pheromone trap at the rate of 2 to 3 taps per acres for the monitoring purpose. Then in case of preventive measures, set up light trap to attract and kill the adult female moth. Then avoid the late transplanting of the crop. Then clipping of leaf tips at the time of the transplanting to destroy the egg masses before transplanting. Then grow high yielding mid late varieties like a Ratna, so on. Okay. Then in case of curative measures, collection and destruction of dead husks and white ears. Then collection and destruction of egg masses. Conservation of frog to keep down the incidence of the stem borer. Then we can use a Trichogramma japonicum. It is one of the mostly used larval parasites against the yellow stem borer. Then dipping of the seedling roots for 12 hours in the 0.02% chlorpyrifos solution before transplanting. Then these are the some of the recommended insecticide to control the yellow stem borer in case of rice cultivation. Fipronil, fluvendamide and chlorantraniliprole we can spray with the help of these chemicals with an appropriate dose at a regular interval. The next one and most important pest of rice is plant hoppers. There are the three plant hoppers. The first one is a brown plant hopper, then white black plant hopper, then green plant hopper. These all the plant hoppers, it is a sucking pest. And sucking pest having a piercing and sucking type of mouth parts and having an incomplete metamorphosis. Hence, they have only three life stages, egg, nymphs and adult. And the damaging stages of these pests are the nymphs and adults. The brown plant hopper is a common in a rain-fed and irrigated rice. But the most important thing is that in the last decade, white, black, plant hopper has tremendously increased in lowland areas where brown plant hopper resistant varieties are grown. This is the most important occasion, or we can say that the incidence of this pest. This is the brown plant hopper. The scientific name is Nil parvata lugens. Then in this brown plant hopper, there are the two types of the, we can say that the adults are formed. In that, the first one is a Macropterus and second one is a Brachypterus. Macropterus are strong flyers and the Brachypterus are weak flyers. Why? Because in case of Macropterus, the wings are fully developed or completely developed. Hence, they are a strong flyers. Then in case of a Brachypterus, the wings are not fully developed. Hence, they are weak flyer. This is the two types of adult found in case of a brown plant hopper. This is the life cycle of the brown plant hopper. Egg, nymphs, adult are the different life stages, and the several generation it is complete in a year. The egg laying it is takes place in leaf tissue on either side of the midrib and the leaf sheath. Then this phase is carry over it over winters either as eggs or fifth in star nymphs through the alternate host plant. and the total life cycle of this brown planthopper is completed in near about 20 to 24 days. What is the actual damage or nature of damage of this pest? Here, the both nymphs and adult, it is congregate on the plant parts and suck the cells up from the lower surface of the leaves. As a result of feeding, it produces a one characteristic symptoms. The symptom is known as a hopper burn symptoms. This is in first picture, this is a hopper burn symptoms. And beside feeding, this pest is also act as a vector for transmission of a grassy stunt virus disease in case of a rice. Now, this is the nymphs, eggs, nymphs and adult, which is here nymphs and adult, it is congregated just above the water level and suck the cells up at the base of the plant, and it produces, we can say that, the hopper burn symptoms. This pest is also excrete a honeydew-like substance which develop a black suitable fungus on the plant parts and which affect on the photosynthetic rate. And this is the infested field by the brown plant hopper, form a circular patches and hopper burn symptoms on the infested field. Then next one is the white black plant hopper, Sogatella furcifera. Nowadays this pest, it become a major pest in case of rice. Here it is also a sucking pest. Egg, nymphs, adult are the damaging stages. These both nymphs and adults suck the cell sap at the base of the plant just above the water level, same likewise a brown plant hopper. This is the life cycle of the white black plant hopper, egg, nymphs, adult, because it is they have incomplete metamorphosis. Then this is the irregular patches form on the infested field of the rice, and it produces hopper mass symptoms by a white black plant hopper. Then last leaf hopper is that the green leaf hopper, is also called as rice just seeds. And this rice just seeds, the egg-laying of the rice just seeds, it is present or takes place within the leaf tissue. The name itself indicates that the green leaf hopper, it means that it, the adult of this pest is look like a green in color. Then there are the three different species of the green leaf hopper which infest the rice crop. The first one is Nephrotetix viruses. Then Nephrotetix nigrophictus and the Nephrotetix cincticeps. They are the three different paddy green leaf hopper species which infest the rice plantation. Then how this green leaf hopper is actually damaged in the field? Here the both nymphs and adults are the damaging stages. They suck the cells up from the lower surface of the leaves. As a result, the leaves turn yellowish and start drying from tip to downwards. Some species is act as a vector. For which vector? Here we can see that the green leaf hopper, Nephrotetix nigrophictus, are reported to transmit rice transitory yellowing and rice yellow dwarf. And Tungro virus disease transmitted by the Nephrotetix viruses is the most serious disease which is spread by the green leaf hopper in rice. Then these are the some of the causes for pest outbreaks. But which pest outbreaks? These are the some of the causes for outbreaks of the different plant hopper in case of a rice area. Which causes? The first one is the use of heavy dose of nitrogenous fertilizer. It is the most important cause. Then heavy irrigation with a constant standing water. Then use of heavy pesticides, especially pyrethroids, resulting in the resurgence. Then continuous cropping of the paddy in both season, monocropping occurs. Then close planting will result in the prevention of aeration and light. Then use of susceptible varieties, and in a low laying areas severity is more. These are the different causes for outbreaks of the different plant hopper in case of rice. Then how we can control these different plant hoppers? This is the ETL level, 5 to 10 hoppers per hill. It is the ETL level of the different plant hoppers. How can manage? By preventive measures, follow allele cropping. Then grow brown plant hopper resistant or tolerant varieties. Then do not use excess nitrogen fertilizers. Then alternate wetting and drying to avoid water stagnation. Conserve the natural enemies like a spider, mealy bugs. Then avoid methyl parathions and pyrethroids to prevent the resurgence. These are the different preventive practices followed to prevent the infestation of the plant hoppers. Then these are the some of the curative practices to control the plant hoppers. In that, the first one is a herding or roving of duck through the field. They pick out the different nymphs of the plant hoppers and eat by them. Then spray the metarhizome and soplib. Metarhizome and soplib is the biofungicides that is mostly used against the leafhoppers. Then these are the some of the recommended insecticides for spraying. The first one is a pimetrozine, buprophezin, flonicamide, and thiamethoxam. We can use these are different recommended insecticide for spraying purpose with a recommended dose at a regular interval to control the plant hopper population in rice. Then next and most important pest, it is gall midge. It is also called as gall fly. It is one of the dipteran pest. Hence the damaging stage of the pest is maggots. If you see the life history, there are the four different life stages: egg, maggots, pupa, and adult. The egg laying of this fly, it lays their eggs on the leaves singly or in a cluster. The pupation of this pest is takes place in the galls or within the silver shoot, and this pest it is carry over in the form of larval stage. And how this pest is damaged? It means that how the maggots of the gall midge or gall fly in rice is damage. After the hatching from the eggs, the maggots enter into the shoots. Damaged tillers turns into the tubular galls, which dry up without bearing panicles. The main external symptom is the silver shoots or gall, which resembles onion. Fully developed gall is a silvery white halo tubes. Attack to rice seedling leads to profuse tillering, and these new tillers often become infested. Profuse tillering and these new tillers often become infested. It means that it directly on the attack on the shoot and produce a gall. The gall formation is major characteristic symptoms, and this gall, it look like a silver shoot. It resembles the onion leaf. This is a nature of damage. Then this is the picture. This picture shows the in left side picture the maggots feeds on apical bud by lacerating the green tissue and inject the chemical. The name of the chemical is cecidogen into the tissue, and this cecidogen chemical responsible for the formation of the gall inside the shoot, and these shoots produce a silver shoots and resemble the like a onion leaf. This is the characteristic symptom. It is the produced by the cecidogen chemical. Then this is the gall in the form of silver shoot. It is look like this, the picture showing a gall. Then how we control the gall midge? In case of preventive control, destroy all wild grasses. Wild grasses like a cynodon, dactylon, and panicum are act as a alternate host in off season for a gall midge. Hence we can remove the alternate host. Then grow resistant varieties like a Pratap, Kunti, Suraksha, Vikrama, Phalguna. These are the different resistant varieties of a gall midge. The removal of affected tillers showing the silver shoots and their destruction will keep the pest under the check. And then if you go for the chemical control, the buprophezin and thiamethoxam are the two important recommended insecticide for the gall midge. We can spray this chemical with a recommended dose at a regular interval. Then next one is gandhi bug, Leptocoryza species. Gandhi bug, it is the most important pest of the rice at a milky stage or grain development or grain filling stage. This is a sucking pest and having a incomplete metamorphosis, so they have a egg, nymphs, adult, different life stages. The nymphs and adult both are damaging stages. Here the both nymphs and adult suck the cell sap from or suck the juice from the developing grains or form milky grains and produce a different characteristic symptoms. The symptoms like that, the brownish spots on the seeds, further individual grains become a brown and discolor and shriveled. The choppiness in grain, choppiness in grains of rice is caused by this gandhi bug. It is a characteristic symptoms. And in case of severe infestation as a result of feeding, the infested rice fields produce a buggy odor. This is one of the characteristic symptoms due to the feeding of the nymphs and adults of the gandhi bug in a rice field. There are the three species of the gandhi bugs which are infest the rice crop. Then if you see the next pest of the rice, it is a leaf folder. This leaf folder is a Lepidopteran pest. Hence, they have a four different life stages: egg, larva, pupa, and adult. The name itself indicates that the leaf folder. It means that the egg laying of this pest is occurs on the leaves, and after the hatching from the egg, the initial instar larva it is fold the leaves and feeding inside the concealed condition by scraping the epidermal layer. The pupation is also occur inside the leaf fold. This is the characteristic symptoms of the leaf folder. Rice cultivation with the high yielding varieties and applications of high levels of the nitrogen fertilizers helps leaf folder becoming a major pest. So why the leaf folder is major pest? Because due to the higher cultivation of the higher yielding varieties and high use of a nitrogenous fertilizers. The larvae of the leaf folds leaves longitudinally and feed the resulting in the linear pale white strip damage. In case of severe infestation, the crop gives a whitish appearance. This is a infested field damage by the leaf folder. Then in the picture we can see the egg laying of the leaf folder. In second picture, it the later instar larva fold the leaves and feeding the inner content of the or scraping the epidermal layers of the leaves. And in last we can say that the larva fold the margin of the leaf blade together with its saliva and feed within by scraping green tissue. This is the rice infested field, which form a white or brown patches on the upper surface of the leaves under severe infestation. The broomstick appearance of the plant. The broomstick appearance, it is the characteristic symptoms by the produced by the leaf folder in a rice affected area. The how we can control the leaf folder? Then the first one is a monitoring. We can monitor this leaf folder with the help of light trap. Then in case of preventive control or preventive measures, to avoid the excess use of nitrogen fertilizers and apply potash at a higher dose. In case of curative control, Trichogramma chelonis, it is one of the most important larval egg parasitoids against the leaf folder. Then spray metarhizum relay. The metarhizum, it is one of the, we can say that, the biofungicides used against the leaf folder. Then spray the BT. BT means Bacillus thuringiensis products at the rate of 2 gram per liter. Then spray the neem based product like azadirachtin. Then also spray the flubendamide and indoxacarb are the chemical pesticides. The next one is the rice hispa. This rice hispa, it is the coleopteran pest, and the have a, we can say that the grubs and adult both are the damaging stages. The adult feed on the epidermal tissue on of the leaves, and the grubs mine the leaf tissue. The white blotches appears on the leaves. In the severe epidemics, leaves dry up and the crop present a scorched appearance. This is the characteristic symptoms of the rice hispa. Next one is the rice caseworm. It is a Lepidopteran pest. Is commonly found in rice field in a low populations. Due to the continuous water stagnation in the fields, it can be build up and cause a severe loss in early stage. In severely damaged areas, the whole crop may have to re-sown and replanted. This is the most important things about the rice caseworm. Feeding damage includes cutting off the leaf tips to make leaf cases, patches of severe defoliation, stunted growth and death of the plant. This is the in picture showing the field damage. This is the caseworm damage in a rice field. There are some of the leaf cases. It is floating just on the water or stagnation water. And then cutworm. The cutworm, the scientific name of cutworm is Agrotis ypsilon. It is a nocturnal pest. This is the Lepidopteran pest. Hence, they have a egg, larva, pupa, adult life stages. After the male-female mating, the female moth lay their eggs on the lower surface of the leaves or in the moist soil. Then after the hatching from the eggs, the larva is emerge out. The larva, it is a nocturnal. It is in a daytime, the larva or the caterpillar of the cutworm, it is a hide in a soil cracks and leaf holes. Then after evening, they emerge and feeding on the leaves from margin up to the midrib. And the name is a cutworm. Just they cut the seedling from the ground level. In case of rice, they cut the swelling from the ground levels. Hence, the destruction is much more than their actual feeding. This is the most important things regarding the cutworms. And this is one of sporadic pests in case of a rice, and it is a polyphagous pest. In case of sewer infestation, the skeletonization of the leaves occurs. Next one is a rice thrips. Rice thrips, it is the most important pest of the rice nursery. It is a sucking pest. They scrap the epidermal layers of the leaves of the seedling of the rice and show a silvery shine patches on the lower surface of the leaves, and plant lose their turgidity or vitality, and it affect on the photosynthetic rate, and yield is indirectly reduced or seedling is indirectly deformed. Then next one is the rice blue beetle. This rice blue beetle, it is a coleopteran pest. These grubs and adult are both at the emerging stages, and both stages are feeding on the leaves of the rice. They scraping in the epidermal layers of the leaves and form a number of white blotches on the surface of the leaves, and field infested field look like this. Then last is a mite. There are the two mites, leaf mite and the panicle mites. The mites are the non-insect pests. It is a sucking pest. They suck the cells up from the all the tender plant parts of the rice, and show a brown necrotic patches, and discoloration of the leaves occurs. This is the infestation of the panicle mites. The mite which suck the cells up from the panicle or peduncle, causing a choppy grain. If you go for the integrated pest management in rice, which are the things we can use in the integrated pest management? Suitable high yielding cultivars with a resistance to key pest. It means that for the control of the key pest, we can use a resistant variety. Then summer deep plowing, optimum planting time, and synchronous planting are the three major practices covers under the cultural control. Then continuous pest monitoring. This is the most important in case of rice plantation. Then determination of the economic threshold level. Then another practices including the cultural practices: optimum spacing, optimum nitrogenous fertilizers, crop sanitations, early croppings, mid-season drying. These are the some of the cultural practices. Then in case of biological control, we can use a different biocontrol agents. For the sucking pest, different Crassophora carnea. We can say that the hoverfly, there are different shield bugs and predator bugs we can use. Then avoid persistent insecticide. It means that avoid the persistentness of the insecticide in the rice field. Then we can use a pheromone trap for the monitoring and mass trapping of the insects. Then need-based insecticide use, eco-friendly and safe insecticide also used in case of rice plantation. These are the some of the points we can cover under the integrated pest management. This is all about the pest of rice and their management. Thank you.